Enough is enough. City leaders are taking a tough approach to curbing violence. WLKY's Tim Elliott gives us an update on the community-wide effort to make our neighborhoods safe.
May 17th, 2012. Shots ring out in broad daylight in West Louisville. In the end, three people were dead.
Everybody remembers that day, and what was so important was how the community responded.
Mayor Greg Fisher says that day was a wake-up call for the city. Something needed to be done.
This is not who we are as a city. Nobody was pointing fingers. Everybody was just saying, how can I help?
1 year ago, the city created the Violence Prevention Work Group. The program is designed to prevent crime and help make our neighborhoods safer.
We want to be the safest city in the world.
There are a total of 42 recommendations they're trying to implement. Mayor Fisher highlighted a few that have already been put in place, including the Suicide Prevention Work Group.
And over the last several years, we've had more suicides than homicides in the community. Any death, whether it's a suicide, whether it's a homicide, whether it's a traffic fatality, it's a death. And we want to understand the issues behind each one of those and work to prevent them.
Because as you know, the government alone cannot make this work happen. It's going to take all of us in this room to really get to the outcomes that we're hoping to get to.
Anthony Smith is at the forefront on this fight against violence. He's responsible for coordinating everyone involved to make sure they're all on the same page.
A lot of people in the community have a lot of passion for this work and want to be engaged and are looking for ways to be helpful.
So far, the mayor says the program has been a success. Overall, crime is down. But Fisher says they're just getting started.
There is a lot of work ahead, but the good news for the community is that people are embracing this work and they understand that it is a journey, but they're happy to be on the journey.
Reporting from Louisville, Tim Elliott, WLKY News.